Let's look at the solution for what happens in our directory Moesi quiz. When course 0 issues a read, it sends a request to the directory. The directory doesn't forward or get any responses, it just sends a response. When there is a write, the course 0 gets this block A in exclusive state, because Moesi has such a state. Course 0 can do the write without telling anybody, so there is no request sent to the directory, and then there is no directory activity as a result of that. When core 1 reads A, it sends a request to the directory. The directory will now send a request to the only core that is involved in sharing this block, which is core 0, so it sends one message. Core 0 responds with the data and acknowledges that now it's okay to read this block, and when the directory gets this message, it sends to core 1 a response. Now core 1 can read the block, so now we have core 1 has the block in the shared state. Core 0 is now in the owned state, because it downgraded itself from modified to owned. Core 2 now tries to read, sends a request to the directory. The directory, if it has only the state that we have seen on the previous segments, does not know who is the owner of this block, but it doesn't need to send anything. So it gets to memory, so pretty much the directory here doesn't send any messages forwarded, because it no longer sees the block in the dirty state. So it doesn't forward anything, it doesn't get responses, it just sends a response back to core 2. Note that here we're unable to benefit from the owned state, simply because the directory doesn't know to ask core 0 to provide the data. With a fancier directory, we would be able to do that, but not with a directory that only tracks presence and dirtiness. So now C2 also has the block in the shared state. The same thing happens for C3's request. There is a request, the directory doesn't forward anything, just sends a response because it has to read the data from memory. And now core 0 writes. Because it's in the owned state, it is not able to write without notifying the directory, so it notifies the directory. This write is an invalidation request because we have the data, but we need to send invalidations to these three processors. So the directory knows that cores 1, 2, and 3, their caches, have the block. So it sends three messages to these three destinations. It gets three responses from each of them. Once they have all acknowledged that they have invalidated, it sends a response back to core 0, and now it's able to write. So overall, we had 5 requests sent to the directory, and that also means that there are 5 responses from the directory, because every request will have a response. The directory has forwarded 4 messages. Note that this is not like 4 out of 5 got messages forwarding. In fact, one of these was for one message, and the other 3 were for the second message. And then we got 4 responses to these messages. Again, every message needs to get a response, because the directory cannot acknowledge and allow a core to, for example, write until all of the sharers have indicated that they have invalidated their state in the cache.